الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولي الصالحين، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا وحبيبنا مولانا محمد الذي أرسلته رحمة للعالمين. أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, towards the end of his life, in which the vast majority of the ahkam, the vast majority of the things that we need to worship Allah correctly had been explained, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, on his hajj, he delivered a speech. And within this speech, it comprises of the most basic, fundamental aspects of our deen. So one of the most important things that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam wished for the Muslims to take notice, to pay attention, and to listen to. And inshallah, this khutbah is going to focus on several aspects of this famous khutbah, this famous sermon. And people have famous speeches. Politicians have famous speeches. People in the army, people throughout history have famous speeches throughout which they are known. And our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is known for many speeches, but this speech is very well known for amongst Muslims and amongst non-Muslims. So please, inshallah, pay attention to his speech, because his speech was given to the Muslims of his time and to every other Muslim who will come after him. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam began his speech in Hajj with all the thousands of Muslims. And he said to them, Ya ayyuhan nas, O people, listen carefully, because I am not sure if I'm going to be amongst you next year. And he began this by catching their attention, letting them know that he is a human being unlike any human being, Bashar, laysa kal Bashar, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, and that he will not be living forever amongst them. And he told them, take these words, and those of you who are present, tell those who aren't present, those who could not make the Hajj, make sure they hear the speech. Those who are not here today, make sure that they hear the speech. Make sure that you tell them. And we went there. None of us were born 1,444 or 43 years ago. None of us were there. But the people, the Sahaba, have told us, have passed down this message to us. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, in one narration of this famous speech, he said, O people, do you know what day this is? What month this is? And what country this is? And then he told them, this is a sacred month, a sacred day, and a sacred place. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam then told them that places and time can be sacred. However, there are things which are also sacred. And the Prophet said, life is sacred, and your property is sacred, and your honor is sacred, your irth is sacred. Every Muslim, his mal, his dam, his irth is sacred. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said, don't hurt anybody, do not oppress anybody, so that nobody oppresses you, nobody harms you. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam said, Allah has made riba haram. Interest is haram. And the Prophet said, and starting from today, all interest is cancelled. And he began with his own house. Abbas ibn Abdul Muttalib, he said that all interest due to him, because he would loan people and he would take money off them extra, is all interest owed to him is cancelled from today. No more interest. And then he, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, mentioned a jahiliya practice, a ada, in which people, qabail, would fight with each other and they would kill one another. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said that this ada, this killing of people from one tribe to another tribe, because somebody's killed somebody from another tribe, is cancelled today. No more indiscriminate killing. No more gang warfare. No more of this qabail, fighting each other. And he began, he said that, and he said, this is all on these, my feet, تحت قدمي. When this jahiliya practice is underneath my feet. And then he, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, made an example and said, and stopped the murder. Then he, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, then went on to explain. He said, don't change the Islamic calendar. The calendar, don't change it. Because the Arabs, they used to make certain days, they would change the calendar. They would bring a month early and delay a month so they could make certain things halal that were haram, because they couldn't fight in a certain month, so they bring the month early. And if they didn't want to fight, they would delay the month, they would change the calendar. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said that this is cancelled. The month is thabit, never to change. And he said the Islamic month has 12 months. The Islamic year has 12 months. 12 months with Allah Azza wa Jalla. So we don't mess around, we don't fiddle with the Islamic calendar to make room or to change. And we don't pretend to sight the moon when we haven't seen the moon. Ramadan comes when we see the moon. And if you haven't seen the moon, you can't say it's Ramadan. The Prophet warned us against this. And then he sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam said, don't change after I've gone. Don't go back to how it used to be. And the Prophet explained, وَلَا تَرْجِعُوا مِنْ بَعْدِي كُفَّارٍ يَضْرِبُ بَعْضُكُمْ رِقَابُ بَعْضٍ. Killing one another. Don't go back to killing one another. Don't go back to killing a Muslim killing a non-Muslim. And look, subhanAllah, look what's happening in Egypt. Killing. And today, wallahu alam, what's going to happen today after the khutbah? SubhanAllah. The Prophet, don't go back killing one another. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned that as shaytan, the devil, has ya'isa, has lost all hope that people will do shirk. In several hadith here, the Prophet said that shaytan has given up on Muslims worshipping other than Allah. And people nowadays are accusing other people of doing shirk. And we say, subhanAllah, the Prophet told us this is not going to happen. The major shirk is not going to happen. Either you're telling the truth and our Prophet is lying, or the other way around. But there's no shirk, khalas. Shaitan has given up on people associating partners, on people worshipping other Allah, as hadith has said. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam has mentioned that shaitan has one more trick. He hasn't given hope on one thing. He's given hope on shirk, but he hasn't given hope on one particular thing. One thing he hasn't given up. One thing he has hope in. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned at-tahrish. And this word at-tahrish is a very interesting word. Many of the ulama of hadith and of lughah have tried to explain what this word at-tahrish means. And they say that it is to incite, to encourage حروب, wars, civil discord, to encourage fitna, tribulation. Shaitan has not given up on causing wars, on causing people to kill, on causing civil war, civil strife. The shaitan is still hopeful and still working. And subhanAllah, we have seen this. People killing each other. As if the Prophet didn't say not to do this. Sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Then the Prophet began taking us in a different direction, but a very important direction. The Prophet began to talk about the women, and he said, fear, اتق الله في النساء, fear Allah in your women. They are a amana, they are trust given to you. لكم حق عليهم. You have a right over them, ولهن حق عليكم, and they have a right upon you. The wife has rights on you, and you have rights on her. And the Prophet said they are helpers, partners with you. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam warned, he said, don't warn it to the women, don't let people into your houses who your husband doesn't like. If your husband doesn't like a particular individual, you should not let people into your house. Or women, don't let people into your house who your husbands don't like. The Prophet warned against this. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam then warned the women to remain chaste, away from fitna. And the Prophet then encouraged the men, provide rizq, provide provisions, nafaqa, provide wealth, look after your women. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, they are trust given to you, so look after your trust. The Prophet then sallallahu alaihi wasallam then took us in a different direction, and he said, whomever has his hammahu is the akhirah, his concern, his thinking, his life is the next life, is Jannah, how to get there, how to make Allah happy. Whoever is thinking about these things, his affairs will be gathered together, will be good, his life will be organized. And wealth, the dunya, because he turned away from the dunya will come to him. Humble, giving itself to him, obeying him. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, as for the one whose hem, his concern is the dunya, how to make more money, how to be rich, more greed, more wealth, more position, the Prophet said, his amur will become mutafarriq, his affairs, shattat shamlu, the Prophet said, his affairs will be scattered, like dust is scattered in the earth. And he will be poor, his eyes, he'll be poor all the time, and only a little of the dunya will come to him. And then the Prophet warned the Muslims, worship Allah, pray 5 times a day, give zakah, and obey those who are placed over you. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, over 1,444 years ago, gave us, he removed racism, he removed tribalism. Although the Muslims have gone back, like they've gone back to everything else, but the Prophet warned, he said, Allah is one, your father is one, there is no superiority over an Arab over a non-Arab, nor a non-Arab is superior to an Arab, nor a white man more superior to a black man, nor a black man more superior to a white man. SubhanAllah. In one line, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi set the foundations to remove this asabiyya, this jahiliyyah, or this tribalism, or this racism. Before Martin Luther King, before Abraham Lincoln, before all these people, who people like to say, these people stood up for rights, civil rights, our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi gave it in his speech. He gave women their rights, and he gave people their rights. And then he sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi sallam said, أَتْقَاكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ, the most honorable in the sight of Allah is those who have taqwa, who fear Allah, who are more conscious of Allah. They are more superior. Not the white, not the black, not the Arab, not the non-Arab, not the old, not the young. The one who has more taqwa, he is more superior to Allah, male or female. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam said, every Muslim is a brother of another Muslim. Every Muslim is a brother of another Muslim. This akhuwa. So the Muslims in China are Muslims to the Muslims in Arabia, and the Muslims in Arabia are brothers to the brothers in China, and the brothers in China are brothers to the brothers in Morocco, and all over the world. We're all one ummah, one brotherhood. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam said, don't take any wealth from people unless they give you permission, unless they give it to you out of their own free will. And then he sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam said, I have left for you two things. If you hold on to these two things, you're not going to go astray. You're going to be ala sirat al-mustaqim. And he said, kitab Allah wa sunnat Rasulullah. The book of Allah and his sunnah, his way. And people nowadays, subhanAllah, they are claiming to follow the Quran and Sunnah and committing acts of terrorism, calling people kafir, or calling people mushrik, all in the name of the Quran and Sunnah. This is not the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. The way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam is bringing people closer, is rahmah, is mercy sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And then he said to them, he warned them, he said, I will meet you in the Akhirah. I'm going to meet you in the next life. And this ummah will be the most numerous, more Muslims on the Yawm al-Qiyamah, to be more Muslims than any other nation. That's fadl min Allah wa ni'mah. And the Prophet said, don't turn back against me. Or in another way, he said, don't make my face black. Don't make my face black. And the Arabs, when they say this, they say, don't upset me. Don't make me sad. How? By going against all the things the Prophet has said. He said, I'm going to leave you. I'm going to see you again in the next life. But make my happy, make my face smile when I see you. Don't make my face angry and upset. And then he, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, said, I am going to intercede on your behalf with Allah. I'm going to intercede. I'm going to plead certain people, certain Muslims, their cases with Allah. I'm going to plead with Allah to allow them to enter into heaven, his shafa'ah. But there'll be some people who I won't be allowed to talk on behalf of. And a Prophet will say, that these are my people. Why can't I speak? Why can't I intercede? Why can't I get their backs, as we say? And will be told to the Prophet, you don't know what they did. You don't know what they did after you left. You don't know how they turned against. They didn't follow your way. They went completely against you. These people today are no longer your friends, are no longer your companions, are no longer your followers. And these people will be dragged to hell. So the khulasa, the summary that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned, five things. And these five things are called the maqasid of the sharia, the higher principles of the sharia. Nowadays many people talk about sharia, sharia law. Maybe many non-Muslims talk about sharia law. But sharia law is based on this khutbah. Sharia law, when the ulama sat, they boiled down the khutbah to five maqasid, five principles. And it's hifd al-deen, hifd al-nafs, hifd al-aql, وحفظ النسح وحفظ المال. Preservation of your deen, preservation of your life, preservation of your intellect, preservation of your lineage and your family, and preservation of your wealth. And we see examples. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us in his khutbah to preserve our deen, follow the Quran and Sunnah according to the vast majority of the ulama. Teach others, convey others. And the Prophet then said, حفظ النفس, preservation of life. Don't kill people. Don't go around killing people unjustly, shooting snipers on buildings, killing women, killing children. This is not the deen of our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And hifd al-aql, preservation of one's mind, that we should be people who don't take things that make our minds, that lose our intellect, like alcohol and drugs. And then hifd al-nasr, preservation of our lineage, that we don't sleep around and have children out of wedlock, because this ruins the lineage. And then finally, preservation of wealth. We don't deal with interest and we don't get involved in these things, and we don't enter into people's houses without permission, and we don't take money from people without their permission. These are the things that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam warned us about. A beautiful khutbah, and mashallah, this khutbah is on a notice board and will be on this another notice board here for people to go and pay attention. Get this khutbah and give it to non-Muslims. Let the non-Muslims see. Let the non-believers see who our Prophet was, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And first of all, you yourself, follow what the Prophet warned you against and ordered you to do, because too much blood is spilt, too much interest, too much zina, too much killing, too much hatred, Everything the Prophet told us not to do, we're doing it one by one, as if the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam had not even spoken. And this is a proof. And at the end, in many riwayat, the Prophet said, have I not told you? Have I not given you this message? Ala ballaghtukum. Have I not told you this message? And everybody says, Na'am ya Rasulullah. Yes, you've taught us. You've passed on the message. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam ended this khutbah and said, ya Allah, I am free from whatever they do. I've passed on the message. I've given it to them. What they do after me, I'm no longer responsible for. So subhanAllah, make the Prophet's face on the day of judgment when he sees you. Don't make his face dark, but make his face happy, because you have followed his advice. عباد الله اعلموا أن أنفع للإنسان في هذا الزمان مثل هذه الخصال.